Right now, it is nearly impossible to get the opportunity to visit outer space. Only about 600 people have ever made it to space, which means you have a higher chance of getting hit by lightning than experiencing space travel. It is likely, however, that space tourism will open up to the general population sooner than we might expect due to the privatization of space exploration. Companies such as Elon Musk's SpaceX, Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin, and Richard Branson's Virgin Galactic are now beginning to open the doors to commercial spaceflight by advancing the technology needed to make this goal a reality. Right now, tickets on their spacecraft are reserved for the ultra-wealthy, with the cheapest option being Virgin Galactic's $450,000 ticket price. These prices are likely to drop dramatically in the coming years now that private corporations are getting involved due to their drive to lower costs and maximize profits. These corporations will depend on creating realistic price points if they wish to expand their customer base beyond a wealthy few. Eventually, it is likely that people will even be spending the night in space in hotels on the moon or orbiting the Earth. While it is hard to predict exactly when this will become a reality, we are hearing of new advancements in the industry pretty regularly now. But will this happen in our lifetime? Elon Musk seems to think so. He expects to accomplish far more than just the ability to take a vacation to outer space. In a Twitter comment thread, he confirmed that his goal is to have 1 million people living on Mars by 2050. Jeff Bezos also has his sights set high, as he unveiled Blue Origin's plan to create a private space station called Orbital Reef, which is planned to be deployed by 2030. Orbital Reef will act as a commercial hub for both research and tourism in low orbit. It is possible that it could be a replacement to the current International Space Station, since NASA has announced it is to be retired by 2031 due to outdated infrastructure. The Orbital Reef Station is just the beginning of many sci-fi worthy plans Jeff Bezos has in mind. One of his more respectable goals is to save the Earth from pollution and resource depletion by moving all heavy industry to space. You see, outer space has way more resources than we could ever want here on Earth. Therefore, we would no longer have the need to mine and destroy the Earth to collect them.
The good news is that if we move out into the solar system, for all practical purposes, we have unlimited resources.
But it doesn't stop there. Bezos dreams of a day when there are colonies in space of a trillion people or more. With all of the energy, resources, and space abundant in the cosmos, we could sustainably support a massive growth in human population.
If we're out in the solar system, we can have a trillion humans in the solar system, which means we'd have 1,000 Mozarts and 1,000 Einsteins. This would be an incredible civilization.
Before we begin to build residential areas in space, we will likely first build government outposts, research centers, hotels, and refueling stations. TransAstra is a company funded by NASA that hopes to turn asteroids into gas stations in space. Refueling at these gas stations will help rockets travel further in space to the point that they are regularly carrying people to Mars and beyond. When driving on Earth highways, we've become accustomed to seeing the names of popular gas stations, such as Axon. In outer space, TransAstra hopes to be one of these recognizable names you see as you travel between celestial bodies. They have claimed they hope to be the Standard Oil of the 21st century as we advance to be a spacefaring species. TransAstra has also created technology that will be used to harvest water from lunar ice caps. The water collected there will be extremely useful as we begin to expand our presence on the moon. The moon will have research centers, a refueling station, and even hotels for civilian vacations. These lunar hotels will have to be underground so that visitors will be protected from the high levels of radiation present there. Once space hotels are open for business, we will likely begin to get increasingly used to hearing about people taking vacations up there. So, you may be wondering, what would a vacation to a space hotel look like? The first large space hotel is set to open in 2027, and it is currently in the development stages. It is called the Voyager Station. It plans to be a cruise ship-styled accommodation for up to 280 guests. The space hotel has an ultra-futuristic design with a circular rotating shape connected by elevator shafts. The interior will resemble a hotel on Earth with common amenities such as suites and restaurants. There will be no lack of luxury on the Voyager station, as there will be top chefs providing fine dining and famous entertainers performing. The CEO of the company building the station, John Blinkow, has stated that he wants to have Sting come up and play, and Beyonce. There will be two shows every night. That's part of the entertainment package. They also hope to offer unique experiences such as low-gravity basketball and spacewalks. The rotated wheel design will create simulated gravity on the outer edges of the station, and thus the rooms that require gravity, such as suites, restaurants and gyms, will be located there. As far as price goes, a high luxury experience like this with a view of Earth isn't cheap. A three-night stay is set to cost $5 million, but the Voyager Station team has stated they're hoping to eventually make this stay equivalent to a trip on a cruise or a trip to Disneyland. In the early phases of humanity building in space, we should expect to see an increase in space tourism. But when will humanity begin to relocate to outer space permanently? And what will our new homes look like? Jeff Bezos sees a future where trillions of humans live in O'Neill colonies. These are gigantic spinning cylinders meant to replicate gravity and offer perfect living conditions for humans. According to Bezos, the weather on these cylinders would be perfect all year long. People won't have to worry about such things as earthquakes, tornadoes, or even rain in these hypothetical cylinder environments. Bezos has also described them as having high-speed transport, agricultural areas, and cities in the background with some design for recreation. Artistic depictions of O'Neill colonies portray what a space utopia might look like, with impressive amounts of greenery and futuristic architecture. This is clearly something that we won't be seeing anytime soon. Bezos respects the fact that these are far-off dreams that would have to be constructed by future generations. He does, however, wish to start building the infrastructure needed to make these a reality.
We have to build a road to space so that our kids and their kids can build the future.
Elon Musk envisions a future where humanity is not only living in space, but is also a multi-planetary species. Instead of artificial environments such as O'Neill cylinders, Musk has his gaze set on Mars. He not only wants to build a Martian city, but he also has a desire to transform the Red Expanse into an Earth-like planet through terraforming. One way to do this would be to heat up the frozen carbon dioxide that exists in the planet's soil, which would create an atmosphere more similar to that on Earth. Eventually, it is hypothesized that Mars could be a planet filled with lush greenery that could sustain an abundance of life. According to NASA scientists, there is evidence that Mars used to have an atmosphere like Earth. So if Mars was a life-sustaining planet before, could we make it return to one? Life on Mars won't be too fun at first. Elon Musk recognizes this as he stated, "Honestly, a bunch of people would probably die in the beginning. You probably won't have good food and all these things. It's an arduous and dangerous journey where you may not come back alive, but it's a glorious adventure." You see, Mars has no running water, no fertile soil, and lacks the oxygen needed for humans to breathe. The atmosphere is 95% carbon dioxide. The surface of Mars is like the moon, largely unprotected from radiation. If something were to go wrong while astronauts were living there, such as food not growing fast enough to feed everyone, there is nothing that could be done to help them. In November 2021, Bloomberg published a fascinating article titled "Urban Life on Mars," which displays what architects, designers, and scientists imagine life on Mars will look like in the future. They envision a city which will act as the Martian capital called Nua. The surrounding cliffs and canyons will act as a rocky shield protecting the metropolis from radiation, so that more than 150,000 people can live there. The cities on Mars are imagined to have green domes, which will be vast artificial parks designed to mimic natural spaces on Earth. These domes will be full of lush greenery and water features like those on Earth, such as rivers. The article also states that it is likely that architecture on Mars will be created via 3D printers. This is Mars Dune Alpha, a 3D printed Martian habitat designed by NASA-funded companies Icon and Big. The Dune Alpha is a depiction of what housing on Mars will look like. This is the habitat's 1,700 square foot floor plan. As you can see, it includes crew quarters, a recreation area, kitchen, fitness room, and treatment room. It is still not clear what governance in space is going to look like, considering the existing international agreements are extremely limited. The United Nations has come out with a series of treaties that attempt to provide a framework for international space law. The treaties have some pretty basic guidelines in them, such as the requirement for space to be explored for peaceful purposes. They also prohibit weapons of mass destruction in space. There really isn't much guidance at all in the treaties. Everything stated in them could be summarized on a single page. The governing treaties set forth by the United Nations also have a lot of limitations. Not only are they very vague in how they can be interpreted, but they are also not up to date in regards to the current rapid commercialization of space. In fact, private corporations such as SpaceX are not bound to these treaties at all. We are, after all, still so early in humanity's migration to outer space. There are countless obstacles to overcome and lessons to learn. Like Elon stated, however, it will be a glorious adventure to embark upon. Would you live in outer space? Or maybe just vacation there? Would you rather live in an O'Neill cylinder or a Martian city? If you like videos like this and want to see more like it, give this video a like and subscribe to TechNeo. Thanks for watching.